Start counting down. Hi, how are you doing? Welcome to Barn Chat. I'm Tabitha Cromer and I'm here with Dr. Cadston. And today we want to talk to you about equine health. I love to ride horses. I think they're wonderful creatures. And Dr. Cadston wants to tell you a little bit about herself.
Thanks, Tabitha. I'm Dr. Jen Caston. I grew up in the Hunter Jumper Barn, actually, showing in the hunter world until I was went to college, and then have been riding recreationally ever since, doing some trail riding and those sorts of things. I completed an equine internship down in Ocala, Florida, at Peterson and Smith, so I have some exposure there, and look forward to sharing my insights with you as we prepare for fall and winter with our equine friends.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for giving us some of your questions. And we'll just start. And again, if you have any additional questions for us, just let us know. We will check the post periodically. And for some reason, if we don't get to you, we will definitely respond after this live event. So thank you again for joining us. And Dr. Caston, one of the first questions is, how will my horse's nutrition change in the fall? Should I do anything different? But first of all, how will my horse's nutrition change?
Yeah, absolutely. That's a great question. And thank you for submitting it, whoever did. So with the change of seasons, we tend to see horses struggle to keep their weight on a little bit more. And that happens for a variety of factors, mostly having to do with the pasture quality. As the season changes from fall to winter, the growing season ends, the quality of our forage declines. So we have to think about other ways to supplement nutrition for our horses. Obviously, the best way to get nutrition for our horses is to have really high quality hay. I realize that may not be possible for all of you out there. That certainly can vary geographically quite a bit. So some other ways you can supplement nutrition is through a pelleted feed or a grain type thing. Adding rice bran can be a great assistant for those hard keepers, those that tend to lose weight in the fall and winter months. And the best time to be to respond to these changes is now. Get ahead of it. If you know you have a poor doer, get some extra condition on them now while the weather's still nice and there is a good access to good quality forage, so that come the winter months, you're ahead of the game.
Awesome. Good deal. And again, if you do have additional questions for us, just let us know. Another question that was submitted, Dr. Caston, is do you have any fall feeding tips?
This kind of touches on what we were just talking about, but making sure you have plenty of really good quality forage for your horse. So hay, depending on your horse's needs and what's available in your area, some combination of a grass hay and a legume would be great. Many of you may feed alfalfa. That can be a dense source of nutrients for horses. And really, your veterinarians and the folks at your farm and feed stores know what the best hay is in your area. That really can vary quite a bit from my experience in Ohio to what's down in Florida to what's out in California. And so there's that. Also, one thing that we ties in with feeding is making sure horses have adequate amount of water. We can't underestimate the importance of water at this time of year. Horses the weather's cooling off, they tend to drink less, and they can really get predisposed to colic from not drinking enough during this time of year as the weather cools down. And so we want to always make sure they have ample, warm, free choice water. If it gets really cold, you have to put a heater in your water buckets. Think about that now. Get ahead of the game. Also, having a salt block, it can also help encourage drinking.
Oh, wow.
And your farm and feed store certainly could recommend an appropriate salt block, or of course your veterinarian.
Sure. And you mentioned that horses could have a tendency to colic. Are there certain signs to look for?
Absolutely. That's a great question. Colic is a big fancy term for gastrointestinal pain in horses. So what that can manifest itself as is sometimes you'll see horses pawing. More dramatically, they can start rolling around on the floor, thrashing in pain, kind of the most extreme cases of colic. Sometimes they're just a little not quite right. They're not drinking as much. You'll maybe notice they're not passing manure normally. Those are some fairly telltale signs. of colic. They don't show an interest in their hay or their grain, and all of those things. Just no, kind of just maybe a little bit distended, not quite right. If you see these signs of colic, I please follow up with your veterinarian. It can be very treatable if it's caught early, but it also can turn into a very serious medical emergency if it progresses. Like I said, my advice is always follow, if you think your horse is colicking, follow up with your veterinarian and get their advice. They may not need to make a phone call. They may have some They may have some suggestions that they can make over the phone, but they may need to come out and assess your horse.
And actually, now that we all have our smartphones, we could probably even take a video.
That would be maybe, a very great way to help. Help your veterinarian diagnose colic for sure.
Okay, awesome. We did get another question in about the weather. It's kind of funny because in Montana, over the weekend, it snowed. Right. We are actually in Texas today, and it's 95 degrees out. So the variation with weather, I know the horses and animals act differently. So with the weather getting cooler, at least in Montana, are there certain things to worry about regarding the horse's health or things to look for?
Yeah, absolutely. Again, we kind of touched on it already about making sure horses are getting enough water. That's the first thing that comes to mind with the cooler temperatures. They're going to be so much more less likely to drink, and, we want them to stay hydrated. We also want them, it helps their gastrointestinal health, their renal health, if they're drinking appropriately. So that's going to be one big thing with as the weather cools down. With the weather changing, that can affect the parasite load on the pastures. Actually, parasites go a bit crazy at this time of year. Cool mornings tend to lead them to replicate a lot. So you certainly want to get with your veterinarian about deworming and running fecal egg counts to see what is most appropriate for your horse. Parasitism can cause all kinds of gastrointestinal and wellness problems. And so if you can get on that, that's really great. Also, another thing to think about with these often cool mornings is that the sugars in the pastures are concentrating. They're not using that energy to grow at night. They're collecting the sugars during the day, the energy during the day, and they're not using that at night with the cooler temperatures to grow. Instead, they're concentrating the sugar in the grasses, which may predispose horses with metabolic syndrome or those that are prone to laminitis. Those horses can have trouble if they're out on pasture at this time of year. So that's certainly something your veterinarian can make more specific recommendations about, but it should be... If you know your horse is predisposed, that should come to mind at this time of year.
Yeah, that's a great point. Another question is, how can I prep my horse so they don't get the equine influenza virus? Or is there a way to prep them?
Absolutely. That's another great seasonal health concern at this time of year. And risk for equine influenza, equine influenza virus is very similar to the human influenza virus or those in other species. So the risks tend to be somewhat similar as well. Age can play a big part of risk, geography, where you are, what you're doing. Is your horse, you know, in a small herd or just a solo horse in a backyard somewhere? Or are you in a big crowded show barn somewhere? Or are you shipping your horse quite a bit? Your previous vaccination history can definitely play into it as well. And so those factors all have to be considered. Depending on those factors, your veterinarian may decide to boost the equine influenza virus vaccine at this time of year and just do a fall vaccination schedule, again, depending on the needs of your horse. And so that can be a great way to prevent it. And they can also give you some other tips for preventing equine influenza. Always keeping the barn well ventilated is a good suggestion. Minimizing contact with other horses, cleaning surfaces, basic biosecurity can really help.
Yeah, those are great points.
Regardless, you know, great for horses, but also kind of regardless of species.
Sure. No, that's excellent. Thank you. Kimberly actually has a question. She says, our horses are drooling this past month. the locals in the area say clover's the cause. Do you have any thoughts? Could clover...
Yeah, that can definitely be the cause of horses drooling. Most horses get better from this problem if they are removed from that pasture. So if it's possible to move them to a pasture that doesn't have clover, that would certainly be your best bet. Your local university state extension service might be able to offer some more specific advice in your area. When in doubt, switching them to a hay that doesn't have any clover in it could help solve the problem. Avoidance is certainly the best remedy for this, but follow up with your extension veterinarian or your state extension service or even your own personal veterinarian for advice.
Awesome. Good. Thank you, Kimberly, for the question. We appreciate it. And again, if you have any other questions, let us know. Another one that popped up was my horse panics when loading and unloading into the trailer. Yeah, any good tips for that?
Yeah. So I think many of us who have been around horses for any length of time can appreciate this one. There's always one that just thinks the boogeyman is in the trailer. And horses are prey species by nature. And so their instinct when they're afraid is to take off and get themselves out of that situation. So one of the best things to do is to help make it a positive experience for them. Mm-hmm. One of the great things that here at Vetoquinol we have is a great product called Zilkine that Tabitha hopefully can show a bit better. This product is a milk-derived protein that can help horses cope with stressful situations a bit better. It's got a great apple flavor. It's very easy to sprinkle on the feed. And that can help you condition, using Zilkine can help condition the horse to make trailer loading a positive experience. And hopefully in time you won't have to give them the Zilkine prior to loading.
Yeah, in fact, you want to tell us a little bit more about Zilkine because it does help in stressful situations. So thunderstorms, new environment.
Shipping, vet visits. If you've got that horse that is terrible for the farrier or the vet, doesn't like his vaccinations, doesn't appreciate what wonderful people veterinarians are, Zilkine can really help. And hopefully in time, again, that horse can learn to cope with that situation and we can get them off the product. So.
And I think what I love about Zilkine, we actually have this for cats and dogs too, and I use it for my cats, but it's not a drug. So it doesn't sedate the animal. They're still very active. It just really helps calm them down. So I personally love this product.
Yep.
And you can get it through your veterinarian if you're interested.
Very nice product. Very palatable too. Your horse will eat it.
So let me ask you this. Someone has sent in a question that now that it's fall, happy fall, everyone.
Yay.
We might not be riding as much as in the spring and the summer. So what are some tactics that need to be taken into consideration for the horse to stay flexible, especially if the horse is a performance type of horse?
Yeah, absolutely. I think one of those things is we want to do what we can to keep them mobile. We take this a bit from physics, but bodies in motion stay in motion. Mm-hmm. So even if you can't get out and ride, doing some rehabilitation exercises can be really great. So even, like I said, if you can't get out and ride, maybe you can get them active turnout with the buddy. They're not just standing in the pasture, they're actually out and moving. Or lunging your horse can be a great idea. There's a variety of rehabilitation therapy. Maybe you have access to a hot walker or an underwater treadmill. Those can all help. They also have a great joint support product, Flexidin UC2, that Tabitha's getting. They can help support joint mobility throughout the fall season. It's actually a very palatable banana flavored product.
It tastes kind of like Laffy Taffy, so it's a great banana. Yep. Tastes very palatable.
Yep, and what's unique about this product is the body recognizes the collagen in it as itself. So it doesn't actually break it down. It's able to reach the joint and really have efficacy where it needs it most, which is in the horse's joints. So that's what we think is really unique about the product and really can help. Again, you can get it through your veterinarian if you're interested.
And it has the, it's Flexit and UC2, so it has the UC2 in it. Mm-hmm. Do you want to talk a little bit about what UC2 means?
So that's the undenatured collagen,
yep.
type 2 yep. collagen that, again, your the horse's body recognizes it yep. as its own.
Mm-hmm.
And so it won't break it down. It won't, the horse's body won't spark an immune response to the product. It actually will be make its way to the joint and where it can help the cartilage heal and repair and stay mobile.
Yeah, in fact, there's a lot of human products that doctors are now recommending that have the UC2. And basically they're saying unless it's got the UC2 product in it, it may not be as effective.
Okay. Yep.
So yeah, we're actually one of the only ones, or probably the only one in our market that has the UC2 that's available.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, and through the veterinarian. And,
yep.
Wonderful. Let's talk a little bit about hoof care.
Okay.
I know you had mentioned earlier about the farriers, and I know not all horses appreciate their feet being touched.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of people, again, with the fall and winter being sort of the off season for many disciplines, maybe taking their horse's shoes off for the season, mm-hmm. giving their feet a bit of a break. You want to keep up with hoof care. So you have your farrier out regularly, or do your, if you're one of those folks out there that does their own trims, all the power to you. But keep up with that hoof care. You don't want to predispose them to any hoof wall problems, any abscesses, any white line disease, anything like that. So the best is to just keep up with the regular farrier trimmings. If any corrective shoeing that needs to happen can happen during the season. This off season, and that way they'll be good to go for the show season or whatever your active season is, if it's come the spring and summer.
Awesome. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, that's it can take 12 months to a year for a hoof to really grow out all the way. So what we do now can actually have a really big impact on a year from now.
Wow.
So that's why it's so very important to stay on it.
Okay. Does it matter if the horse is actually in the pasture most of the time during the fall, winter, or if they're in the barn more?
That may impact hoof health. Absolutely. Okay. Certainly moisture can play a big part in it. So if they're out on a wet surface, then they're going to be, more predisposed to hoof rot and, having issues with their hoof wall breaking down.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Abscesses, those types of things. So if we can keep them on a nice dry surface, that's best. But if they're not working to manage those, hoof conditions is the best.
Okay, yeah, that's great feedback. I actually did not know that, so that's great feedback.
There you go.
Let's talk a little bit, and again, if you have any questions for us, please let us know. We're covering today hoof care and any type of questions for equine. We've discussed our Equestro product, which is the Flexidin UC2,
yep.
which UC2 is very, very important for horses. And we also discussed the Zilkeen
yep.
equine, which is great for horses that are in stressful situations. So we want to go on to our next topic, and it's dental care. So let's talk about dental care for the fall.
Absolutely. This is the fall is a great time to have your veterinarian out to take care of oral health. People don't realize that a lot of equine problems can stem from their mouth. They mm-hmm. think that some behavior problems it's hard to associate that with their mouth, but actually their teeth can play a big role with how bits fit in their mouth, their digestive health. If they're not chewing their hay properly, that can predispose them to colic. So we always, as veterinarians, we recommend horses have their teeth floated once a year until they're about 18 years old, and then after that, twice a year. Fall's a great time to have your veterinarian come out and do that for you. Maybe they're doing it with your fall vaccines.
Mm-hmm.
So that can be a really good time. Check for any hooks or points, address any imbalances in the mouth, make the mouth happy and comfortable, and let your horses continue to eat well into the fall and winter.
Are there any certain symptoms or signs to look for that maybe, I don't know, they have a cavity or maybe a loose tooth or something wrong? I mean, is it the way they chew? Or
it could be the way they chew, absolutely. Mm-hmm. A lot of people notice if they're riding their horses that sensitivity to the bit, that's a big problem. Sometimes people will notice halitosis, actually. And like, it really stinks. Or sometimes, depending on if it impacts their sinuses, they can, the only symptom of a problem tooth can be a snotty nose.
Oh, okay.
So those are kind of the more extreme situations, but I certainly have seen that in practice where a snotty nose, the only sign of this persistent snotty nose was, or the only problem sign of the tooth was this problem was a persistent snotty nose.
Sure.
So, and those are all things your vet can check for when they come out to flow their teeth.
Wow. Okay. Let's touch base again, just real quick, regarding the flexibility of the joints.
Mm-hmm.
Because with fall coming up, like we had mentioned earlier, you may not ride your horse as often.
Mm-hmm.
So one of our employees loves to ride, and he had mentioned that once he started giving his horse the Flexidin UC2, he can definitely tell a difference. Now, granted, this was, you know, during the summer.
Right.
But also, his horse is over 15 years old.
Yeah.
So it's not a young one.
Right. And that's a great thing. You raise a great point that our older horses, much like older people, are more inclined to have a joint arthritis.
Yeah.
And that varies on where the location of that arthritis is going to be. It may vary very on what you do with the horse.
Mm-hmm.
The hocks are a common area. The fetlock can be a common area of arthritis. It really stifles. It just depends. The navicular bone and quarter horses can be a problem area. It just depends on the type of horse you have and what you're doing with it. But the Flexidin UC2 can definitely help with that. Great for older horses. Like I said earlier, joints in motion stay in motion. So the more we can work them, the better effect you're going to work. One thing that I think is important to keep in mind with this product is that it's not going to work overnight. We're going to have to, the horse needs to be on it for probably 4 to 6 weeks or so before you're really going to appreciate the maximum benefit from it.
Right.
And so that is an important thing for any of you that are interested in the product. This isn't an overnight fix. This is a joint health supplement that will, you'll see progress, but it's going to take a little bit of time.
So. But the good thing is you will see a difference. I mean, that's what everyone has told us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even if you use the loading dose or if you just start with the regular dosage, every single person has come back and has just been just basically floored by how well it works and the effects. Awesome. Well, wonderful. Well, is there anything else that you would like to...
Let's see. I think there's some other just kind of general fall tips I would offer you, since most of you in the equine world have farms or stables. Fall season's a great time to do basic barn maintenance. Mm-hmm. Rotate your hay in your hay loft. Get the older hay out to the front. Use it first. Again, we're trying to keep the best quality hay possible for our horses. It's a great time to clean your barn. To minimize any risk of infectious disease. Certainly anytime you travel with your horses in your trailers, especially if you've gone to a show or somewhere where they're going to have contact with horses outside their herd, you'll want to do some good biosecurity there and clean. I always recommend rodent control. I can't underestimate that enough. Unfortunately, rodents can spread a variety of infectious diseases that can infect both horses and humans. So we always want to keep the barn as free of those as possible. And otherwise, have lots of clean water, clean appropriate temperature water for your horses, and address their changing nutritional needs as the fall progresses. And when in doubt, get in touch with a veterinarian. They're a great source of information for you. Fall is an awesome time to do some wellness with them and prepare for a successful winter season.
Wonderful. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. And again, if you have any questions, definitely email us. You're more than welcome to visit our website. It's barnchats.com. And Dr. Katzen would love to answer additional questions, even in the next week or so. Yeah, definitely keep them coming. And we will be launching more Equestro products that we're very excited about. And we'll let you know more on our next live. So thank you so much and have a wonderful day.